Everyone, assalamu alaikum. Well, previously we built this Firebase app where we are able to insert data into Firebase and then we are able to add it to them or delete to them like this, okay? Now, some of you have requested how to view the data or the documents separately, okay? So that's what we'll cover in this tutorial. Okay, now let's recap something what we learned earlier, recapture. Now here previously we learned that we had this stream builder and it helps us to build constant connection or get the data from Firebase, and we get the data and bind with our app using this snapshots, and we provide it to stream. And over here we have this async snapshot and we created an object we call it stream snapshot. Now from stream snapshot we can get all the data using dot data, and previously we have seen that in Firebase when we create record, so they are saved as documents like a row. So each document is a row like in MySQL database, okay? And now we get the number of rows, so that's the length. And then from the same row, we know that, so this contains the rows and we get each row or one row from the rows using index, okay? And then we created a document snapshot object and we save it over here, okay? So that's what we have done before. And after that, we are passing the name and price to view them, and that's what we see over here. So now in this section, we'll see if we click on them, how to view them, okay? So go to a new page and view. So that's what we'll cover. Well, to do that over here, we'll create a new icon button. Right now I have this two icon button and we see them here. So here we'll create a new icon button. That's what I'll do. So to do that, first I'll go ahead and copy this one, okay? And I'll put it right below there. And instead of edit, I'll change the name of this button. We'll call it dot view. Let's see what do we get. Yeah, okay, so we'll choose the first one. Now of course we want to go to a new page, so we can't use this method, the one we have used early. Now let's go ahead, save it and run it, and let's see how it looks like. So what do we want to do? We want to be able to click on this and go to a new page, okay? Now to go to a new page, definitely first we have to create the new page, okay? So we'll create a new Dart class. And then over here, we'll create a stateless class. Okay, and right over here, we'll have a container. We want to put everything in the center of the new page. So over here, we'll get the width of the screen. So we'll use media query to do that. So what do we have to do? On the onPress event, we'll call this class, okay? And we want to pass this document snapshot, okay? For each row, for a certain row, we'll pass this document snapshot, okay? Remember, it runs in a like a for loop, and during each loop running or during each iteration, it creates a new object from the row and it puts over here in the document snapshot, right? So that's what we want to pass over here. Okay, so first thing, what we have to do, we need to remove this section over here, and over here we'll do navigator.push. Okay, now here we need to pass a context and that's what we already have, and now here's the route. Route name is like where you want to go and how you want to go. So for that one, first we'll use material route page. I think they call it page route, I'm sorry. And over here, we need to pass a context, and that's what we'll do. And then we'll pass the class that we created, and here we'll call it detail page, okay? Now over here, we want to pass the snapshot we have during each loop running, okay? So we'll copy the snapshot and we'll put it over here, okay? of course we'll get an error. So we'll come over here and we want to receive that object, okay? So that's what we want to do. So here we do final document snapshot, okay? And we'll create an object over here. So we'll call it document snapshot, okay? Over here, this would be a required parameter. So here we do required this dot document snapshot, okay? So as we are clicking on this button, let's see. Okay, now because it's a named parameter, so I have to pass it like this. Okay, so named parameter should have a name. So this is the name, and this name contains this snapshot. But of course, you can name it anything. Yeah, that's all. So now as we are over here, we click on this and view the data. Okay, now what we want to do, we want to wrap it around a scaffold so that we can come back and forth. Okay, now we'll have the body and we'll put our column like this. Okay, so what we'll do, we'll save it and hot reload. And after that, we'll be able to click on this. We can go to this page. That's what we see. And we can come back. Okay. All right. Now it's time to view the data. And we already passed the document snapshot as we are clicking on them right over here. So we are passing the document snapshot. Okay, cool. So what we'll do over here, first we'll create a text box or text. Here we'll do document snapshot, and we have a name property inside it, if you remember from the previous tutorial. Okay, all right, now let's go ahead and hot reload and let's restart. I'll click on this and here we see hats, right? Great. So that's how it works. And we can create a size box over here, and here we'll do say height 20. Okay, all right. And right after this, what we'll do, we'll copy this one. And here, instead of name, we remember from the part one that it has price. That's what we'll have. Now, of course, here this error, because it's a double, we need to convert it to a string. Okay, all right. Okay, the error is gone. Now that was for hats. And we can click on the shirt. Yes, we see the view. All right, great. So yeah, so that's how you pass a document or a row to a new page and view the data. Anyway, thank you so much. So if you liked it, don't forget to smash that like button and subscribe.